friends. I have an Etsy order of a pet portrait that I have to work on today. So I thought I will take you along and show you my process from start to finish. Today's portrait is going to be 8 by 10 inches. And these are some of my listings on my Etsy shop for the 8 by 10 format. And it has a more simple banner style than my 9 by 12 inch ones. And this client, she specifically requested this banner style, which has some pen outlines and has a bit of a vintagey vibe. So this is the banner style I'm going to use for this portrait. And I'm going to link my Etsy shop below in case you guys are interested and want to check it out. And this is Tony, our model for today. And this is going to be my main reference image because it has good posture. And I think a good reference photo is a one that when you look at it, you can automatically imagine the finished portrait. However, this one doesn't have great lighting because it's a bit backlit and the face is all dark and gray. If possible, you want to have many photos because they might give you information that your main reference photo doesn't give you. For example, in this one, you get a much better idea of the natural coloring of his fur. It actually has quite a bit of caramelish brown in it, which isn't really visible in this photo. Okay, so here I have my 8 by 10 inches frame, and I don't know if you can see it, but I have roughly sketched out the size I want it to be and then where the banner is gonna go. I think tracing can be a controversial subject when it comes to art, and I don't do it in general, but when it comes to custom painted portraits where the resemblance is quite important, I think it's okay to trace because it saves me on sketching time, which I can put towards painting. I also don't just blindly trace it, but rather roughly mark things and refine my sketch later freehand. I think that way your lines stay alive and you feel like you contributed something to the sketch. When I work with watercolor paper, I almost never sketch directly on it, but always trace a base sketch because I need to erase a lot while I sketch. All right, sketch is done and I cut it out so it is 8 by 10 inches. Because I was using a 9 by 12 inch watercolor pad. Okay. Painting white animals on white background is always tricky. I'm not a watercolor purist, so I'm just gonna paint the white highlights later with gouache instead of coloring around them. But if you don't want to use gouache, you can of course use masking fluid. As always, I like to put down an overall base color and sculpt my subject first before getting into any details. When I watched the filmed footage, I realized that among all the pets that I could have painted for this video, this particular doggy wasn't the most exciting to watch. It's just that there isn't much color going on, but still a lot of subtle detail in the fur, which took me a while to build up, and it was a slow process. So to make things a bit more interesting, I thought I could show you some of my other portraits, including my earlier work. I've been painting pets through my Etsy shop for about 6 years now, and this is probably the one thing that I've been doing so consistently that I can actually see how my style evolved. I'm not saying that my shop is very successful. In fact, compared to other pet portrait artists, my shop hasn't grown significantly since I first opened it. Mainly because it was never my main focus, but just a side thing that I've been doing here and there. But regardless of the success measured in numbers, I'm pretty proud of my portraits, and I have many loyal repeat customers, which makes me think that there is value in what I do. To be honest, sometimes I wonder if I should stop doing these portraits because the way I do it, I feel like it's too much effort for the money and not really sustainable. But with pet portraits, you get such a strong emotional reaction to your work from the person who receives it, which is very moving and really the reason why I'm doing this. I mean, of course, painting cats and dogs is super fun too. But it's really the feeling that your art makes someone else happy, which makes it hard to quit. Normally, my shop isn't too busy except for around certain holidays, so for now I can still keep up with it as a small side job. Anyways, so that's how I ended up painting hundreds of cats and dogs over the years, and I think I did develop a signature style for my pet portraits, which I would say is semi-realistic with just a hint of stylization. The stylization part happens mainly in how I paint fur, which I tend to approach more as shapes rather than texture. It's hard to explain, but I think that's what it is. I also try to give them as much character as possible by emphasizing certain features, but honestly, most of it comes from the eyes. So as I said earlier, painting cats and dogs consistently helped me develop a style, and I wish the same thing would happen with my other areas of work. For example, children's illustration, which is my main focus at the moment. But consistency is my biggest issue and something I struggle with the most. I also think it's the key to getting any meaningful results and even to success. As an artist, we all wish to find our own voice and develop our signature style. Artists who have already accomplished that often tell us to just keep creating and that the style will develop organically, which sounds kind of simple, but it is so true. I think even if you start out copying someone else's style, if you are consistently working, it will eventually be influenced by your own personality, your preferences, your habits, your inspirations, and become yours. So yeah, basically what I want to say is, you and I should take my experience from consistently painting pets and apply it to our main area of work. Or you're probably already doing it, so it's more for me. And in the meantime, I think I'm finally done with this portrait. I actually had to repaint and refilm the whole thing because the first one didn't turn out well. As I said at the beginning, painting white fur is not the easiest. Look at it. I haven't put much effort into packaging for a while now, and to be honest, most times I would just put the painting in a cellophane sleeve, add a business card, stick on my logo sticker, and that's it. But lately I feel inspired to zhuzh up my packaging a bit, and today I'm using tissue paper and gold washi tape. When I first started my shop, I was very into pretty packaging, and I would even throw in my illustrated greeting cards, which were my first and failed items for my Etsy shop. But that's another story. In Korea, we have a saying that goes something like, "Remember your beginnings," or "Don't lose your initial passion," which is something I think about every now and then. It's the next day from when I filmed the intro, and I am finally ready to drop the painting off at the post office. What happened is I filmed myself painting the whole portrait, and then I ended up not liking how it turned out. And it's actually the first time I had to repaint a portrait just because it didn't turn out well. There were like a few times where I misspelled the name, or I got like a drop of color on the white paper, but never because it just didn't turn out well. So the thing is, well, this is the portrait I did yesterday. The color is just awful. It is so muddy and it just looks like a zombie doggy, I have to say. So yeah, I tried to fix it a little bit with lighter gouache paint, but then I decided I might as well just repaint it. Now that I repainted the whole thing, I am really glad that I did. At the end, the most important is that you are satisfied with your own artwork and your client is satisfied with the artwork. I am going to rush to the post office now because I promised the client to send off the portrait this week. So today is Friday. I might have to go to a post office that's further away because it's already over 4 p.m. But yeah, I am going to go now and send this off. So I got here at the post office literally 5 minutes before they were closing, but I was able to drop off my painting, which was good. And I think I'm gonna end this video here. I filmed this outro like 5 times now, I think, and this is just my last attempt. I'm gonna end this here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was somewhat helpful. If you did like it, please click like and also subscribe. And I hope to see you all soon in my next video. Bye!